Right. So that's the person over there.
It's always a pleasure to greet one of our own.
I bet it is. Mythal. Okay. This is another one of the. This is like the. Yeah, we'll read about her right now, but she's like kind of the opposite of the Dreadwolf of Fenhurel. So this crazy name had defeated his father, the son, and all was covered in darkness. Pleased with himself, the crazy person sought to console his mother, the Earth, by replacing all that the sun had destroyed. But the Earth knew that without the sun, nothing could grow. She whispered to him this truth and pleaded with him to release his father. But his pride was great and his vengeance was terrible, and he refused. It was at this moment that Mythal walked out of the sea of the Earth's tear and onto land. She placed her hand on his brow, and at her touch, he grew calm and knew that his anger had led him astray. Humbled, he went to a place where the sun was buried and spoke to him. Sun as in S-U-N, not S-O-N. It's important. He said he would release the sun if the sun promised to be gentle and return to the earth each night. The sun, feeling remorse at what he had done, agreed. And so the sun rose again in the sky and shone his golden light upon the earth. He and Mythal, with the help of the earth and the sun, brought back to life all wondrous things that the sun had destroyed, and they grew and thrived. And that night, when the sun had gone to sleep, Mythal gathered the glowing earth around his bed and formed it into a sphere to be placed in the sky, a pale reflection of the sun's true glory. So that's how the sun and the earth has been made in the world. It is cool hearing this kind of stuff, because you get a little bit of it. Get a little bit of it on the previous games. Just a little. And it's nice that they've kind of gone full elf here. Like, you get a lot of elf stuff. Don't get me wrong. You get a lot of elf stuff in Origins. Because they do, like, they introduce you to the concept of the elves being, like, super pushed down upon with all the racism there. Like, the rampant elven racism. And then what ends up happening is you get a little bit more Dalish story when you go into the I don't remember the name of the forest and Origins, and that's cool. I like that. And then you get a lot of alienage story in, like, in how that all works in Dragon Age 2. I did see that Veilfire back there, don't worry. And I like that, but we're kind of getting the rest of the Dalish story here. Now, let's be completely, you know, transparent here. The books are where you find most of this information. Not in the game. I'm not talking about the books in the game. I'm talking about, like, the actual Dragon Age books. And in fact, I think there's a lot of stuff there also in the Dragon Age RPGs. Not the games, the, like, tabletop RPG stuff. So if you were really interested in, like, the elven lore and how that all works, that's a good spot to go. Oh, that's where the game, like, froze up for a second. Let me just fix something just to make sure that that doesn't happen again. Okay. Cassandra? Smash that open. Me, I will come down here. And I'm looking for not that. Okay, whatever. Just stealth. We'll leave my Veilfire there. Die! I hate that. I hate how they can just, like, dodge out of my way. It doesn't feel good as a rogue player. Him. Or it. I don't really know if these demons are male or female. Cleanse that. Cassandra. Run and dubstep. Alright, switch back over. Stealth. Take him out. Man, this place is really pretty. Oh, that was my point with that whole thing. Back to, like, previous episode when I was talking about, like, the photographic technique that they use in Ethan Carter. My whole point of that was to say that we might see that same technology used and same technique used in Mass Effect and other Dragon Age games to come out. Maybe. I like the idea that that could be a thing in the near future. Because, of course, you know, it would make the game look a lot better. Especially if they, like, nailed the aesthetic of it. I think it might be harder to do in a Dragon Age game. Because it is got the fantasy look. But, you know, like, foliage and, like, stone texture, like this stuff here. You could totally do that kind of thing with. But, you know, you can't take a picture of a dragon, like, IRL. Like, that's not going to happen, right? Which means there's just some things that you gotta texture yourself.
Veilfire.
Right. Now, I don't know if I got the thing, so I'm gonna look around for it. In fact, I should probably open that map back up. Here, I think it's on the other side. Is it? No? What the heck? I know it's around here somewhere. Oh, is this it? Did I already get it? I think I already got it. That's cool. I do hear something. I have no idea what that was. Don't ask me. Okay, so I'm going to check my map. No, there's still glyphs. Appear to be pieces of a greater message. Right, but yeah, I have no idea where this stuff is. Maybe, okay, hold on. I'm going back into the ruins. Sounds like I'm missing something. So every time I walk through that area, I hear something. Maybe there's something down here that I missed? Where am I even at? No. Oh, there's the thing on the wall. Aha. Nice. Okay, and then that was the glyph. Got it, we're done. Did you just retract that comment that you put in the comments that was super ragey? The fact that I couldn't find that. I got it, guys. I figured it out. And from here, I can go, there's something down off over here. I don't know what it is, it's just a dot on my, oh my gosh, a wolf. It's a dot on my map. On the, map in front of me, not the map in the game. These maps do help a lot with figuring out that optimal zone playthrough, though. So you can kind of see, like, the layout of everything. And typically, you kind of see a pattern, like a circular pattern. Like, oh, I should follow these things. Those guys are being attacked by wolves. Who do I want to kill first? The wolves? Or the guys? Probably the wolves. Alright. Can I put him to sleep? That would be funny. Go to sleep now. Wreck them all. Also wrecked the camp. Not that it needed to do that, but it was funny. I got relation to, oh, that's the requisition. Gotcha. I was like, I don't remember picking up that quest. That was the requisition, that's why. Is that the Golden Halla? It is! That might be what that is then. On my map. No, whatever's on my map is back this way. Yeah, I'm gonna go look at it and see what we find. Some birds. That's not what I'm looking for. What could it be? Is it up here? Map. It's like right, like right there on this map. Look, I got nothing. I don't know what the heck this thing is. Is it over there? Because there's not. No. I tried, guys. Oh, whatever that is. I can't loot it, though. Okay, whatever. I'm off. That might be another quest, in fact. All right, let's mount up and let's get this golden Halla back to them. And then there's like a set of ruins over there that you see. By the way, if I was this Halla, I would totally run away from this Draculus. It's terrifying. All right, so let's like shepherd him back. Not like shepherd from Mass Effect, but you know, like sheep herder. He's actually going like exactly where I want him. No, I had to speak up, didn't I? No. Dang it. Freaking Halla. I just almost tried to do the double sprint thing that you do to sprint in Witcher when you're on your horse. Okay, I need you to go this way. Now, that way. Yeah. You're getting it. No, yes. Okay, now that way. Good Halla. You ain't no, you ain't no Halla back. You ain't no Halla back. No, damn it. We got demons coming. Demons? No, where the F are you going? Gosh, I hate this quest. They need to not make these quests ever again. And if they do, it needs to be not this. Okay. I swear, if you start running off the other direction again. We were so close, Halla. You and I, we were like besties, and then you just took off the wrong direction. Okay, I need you to go right. Now I need you to go kind of left. Yeah. You know what? Just thank you. There you go. Hop right up over there. You're glorious, Halla. Where are you going? That way. Thank you. I did it, guys. Off my mount. Sup, dude?
Look, already she makes herself known to the others. She knows she's meant to be here. Thank you, Lethaline. I will never be able to express my gratitude.
Right, okay. Back on my crazy mount. How do these Dales not just like look at me and freak out? Riding a dragon horse. I mean, if I saw this thing, I'd freak out. Look how ugly it is. It's rad looking. It's pretty in its color, but it is kind of not malformed. That's not the word I'm looking for, but it's got an aggressive form, which can be a bit scary. Okay, now that we've finished those, we have this other little area down over here, which leads us into quite a cool area. Just hop off my mount. Climb it. No. Off. I'll leave you in the shrubs. Okay. Now we go into there, and pretty much just like right over there.
Tread lightly. This is sacred ground.
But there are demons. I want to imagine Solas as like Decker Kane, but he's too much of a prude. Decker Kane's way too cool for that. Could just destroy these for loot. That's rad. And I might. But I don't know. What is this quest? In fact, let's look at the quest first. There's an old Dalish burial site in the plains known as Var Blarness. Spells protecting the dead there have been broken, attracting demons. Cleansing the ground of demons would gain favor from the Dales. Sure, we can do that. Probably shouldn't destroy things, though. They may not like that. Despite the fact that there's probably something good in one of them. I feel like... Ooh, but I will loot that. I feel like from a character perspective... I know it's just loot. It doesn't really matter much, but I think my character, when it destroyed this thing in Dalish Elf, if I was like human or something else, totally. Respect the dead, man. Respect the dead. Maybe I have to for the quest, though? Like, that might be a thing. I have to come back out anyways, right? So let's go down into the ruins. And see if we can, like, cleanse it that way, maybe? Save. Requires tomb key, which means I need to get it out of one of these. Should have seen that coming. Ooh, chest of some sort? Yep. It's like a perpetual bad loop. It's a symptom of a much larger issue. Eh, 75 gold. That's not bad. Slowly making my gold back. After using it all on decoration that I haven't actually used yet. Don't worry, I'll get there. Tickle that. Ah, old key part. Wow, I have to find parts of a key. Man, I didn't, like... If it didn't progress my story forward for them, I don't think I would do this. Because I feel like I am kind of desecrating. But there are demons coming out of it, so am I desecrating or am I cleansing? Right? Tomato, tomato. At least you get me XP. Loot, okay. I'm skipping over those plants. Don't really need them at the moment. One more piece. This I could see why people like would complain about the game feeling like an MMO. It's like quests like this. Where you're like, really? It's like, I think I broke something. It's like an MMO quest where you have to collect like wolf hides, right? And you kill like, you have to collect 10 wolf hides, but you end up killing like 25 of them. Because not everyone dropped a wolf hide. And you're like, wait. I killed a wolf, right? Like, that's what that should drop. It just doesn't make sense. Loot in general doesn't make sense to me sometimes, like, especially in RPGs. Did I? Okay, I did. Like when you think about, I don't know, like the fact that, let's go back to the wolf because it's a good example. Like in RPGs, loot is like procedurally dropped. Like, every time you kill something, it has a chance of dropping something good. And I like that. But a wolf should never be carrying like a legendary sword on it or an epic sword on it. That shouldn't happen. But it happens in RPGs. Sometimes, especially MMOs, feels weird to me. Oh, that was weird. I think it's having to load a whole new area under here. That's fine. I think it's a whole puzzle too. All right, it's quick save time. Let's get into some tomb raiding.